Let's prepare our hearts with a silent prayer.
我们一起同心默祷预备心。
Amen. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we begin our first doctrinal study session.
奉耶稣基督圣名开始我们第一节的这个教义查考。
So peace to all our ministers and brothers and sisters who have joined us online this Sabbath afternoon.
愿现在线上参加的弟兄姐妹、传道、长老、执事大家平安。
We give thanks to our Heavenly Father for this wonderful opportunity to gather together online.
我们感谢主赐给我们这个美好的机会，在这个网上一起来聚集。
So that we can learn and equip ourselves with the doctrine of the one true church.
使到我们可以在这个独一真教会的这个教义方面得到更好的装备。
Let's first rise and sing hymn 171.
我们首先一起起立唱诗171首。
Please be seated.
请坐。
So today's doctrinal study, as you can see, will be led by Preacher Stephen Shek.
我们今天的这个教义查考是由我们石文斌传道来带领。
So after part one of the topic, we will actually have a group sharing.
我们讲完了这个第一个部分之后，有分组的分享。
It will be split into two groups, English speaking and Mandarin speaking.
大家会分成两组，就是中文组还有英文组。
After which, we'll then continue with part two of the topic.
然后我们再来分享这个独一真教会的第二个部分。
And finally, we will have a Q&A session where Preacher Stephen will answer some of your questions and also some pre-prepared questions as well.
然后我们再有一个问与答，就是我们的传道会回答一些预先准备的这个问题，或者是大家有的一些提问。
So in the book of Philippians, it charges us to work out our own salvation with fear and trembling.
腓立比书告诉我们，我们要战战兢兢地做成我们得救的功夫。 Your mic is off.
With this in mind, let us make use of the next 4 weeks.
我们要考虑到这几点，我们这四个礼拜，我们要好好的利用这个时间。
To diligently fortify our understanding.
来巩固我们对这个教义的这个了解。
To strengthen our faith that the true Jesus Church is indeed the one true Church of God.
使到我们真正的能够确信明白真耶稣教会是神独一的真教会。
So in our prayer, we ask God to guide today's doctrinal study.
在我们祷告当中，我们求神来带领我们今天下午的这个教义的查考。
We'll humbly ask the Spirit to open our hearts.
我们谦卑地祈求圣灵来开启我们的心。
To receive the teachings of God.
使到我们能领受这个神的教训。
Which can make us wise for salvation.
使到我们能有得救的智慧。
So let us pray in one accord.
我们现在要一起同心合意地跪下祷告。
If you are comfortable, please unmute your mics.
如果你觉得没有问题的话，你可以打开你的这个。 这个麦克风来一起祷告。
Let us pray.
一起祷告。
In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Thank you. Amen. So first, we invite Peter Stephen to lead the One True Church Doctrinal Study.
我们现在邀请我们的石文斌传道来带领我们这次独一真教会的教义查考。
Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus Christ, I speak.
Hallelujah, 奉主耶稣圣名说话。
We thank our Lord Jesus Christ that we have this opportunity to improve our knowledge of our basic doctrines.
感谢主赐给我们这个美好的机会，来能够让我们对这个教义上有更进一步的学习。
This indeed is a very good opportunity for us to improve because our spiritual knowledge is for our salvation.
这个让我们进步的这个机会是非常美好的，因为我们这个属灵的知识能够增进我们得救的机会。
And we also know that we need to pass down this knowledge of salvation to others as well.
我们也知道我们必须将这个得救的知识传达给其他的人。
So in our study of the doctrines, we are going to begin with One True Church.
所以在这个教义的查考方面，我们先开始是学习独一真教会。
So what is a doctrine?
教义是什么？
What is the definition?
教义的定义又是什么？
From here, we can see that the Greek word means creed, teaching, principle, or dogma doctrine.
这个希腊文它的原文的意思有信条、教训、原则、教条或者是教义的这个意思。
Yeah, so that is the Greek word for doctrine.
这就是这个希腊人这个教义的原文。
And so the Greek word has various definitions in English: creed, teaching, principle, or dogma or doctrine.
所以它的希腊文的原文有不同层面的意思。 包括信条、教训、原则、教条或者是教义。
So when you listen to the sermon and you see they hear from the speaker talk about God's teaching, God's principle, the doctrine, this is how we should take it.
如果你在听 这个正道的时候，你听到这个教训、原则或者是教义 其实是出于一个 同一个根本的字眼。
Yeah, so the central meaning is that doctrine is God's command and God's rule.
那中心的核心的定义就是这个是神的诫命或者是规章。
It means that it cannot be changed.
啊，就是说不可以更改的这个神的这个诫命。
And so one of the reasons why we are studying the basic doctrines is that over time we know that there are people who are speaking heresies and changing our basic beliefs.
啊，我们为什么要学习教育呢？因为我们知道有啊。很多的人在不同的时间，他们啊在啊啊传达这个异端，要试图要更改神的这个教义。
As the prophecies in the book of Daniel is being fulfilled, that the knowledge is increasing, without a doubt, the heresies will also increase as well.
啊，我们知道这个但以理书里面的预言现在不断的这个实现，就是人的知识会不断的增长。同一个时间，这个教义也会同样不断的层出不穷。
And so therefore, today in our church, there are members or even workers that are still part of the True Jesus Church, are moving towards new beliefs.
那现在在真耶稣教会的一些信徒，甚至是一些工人，他们虽然还在真耶稣教会，但是他们已经转移他们的。他们的信仰去信从其他的教训。
And so therefore, we find it that there is a gradual water down of the doctrines and transforming of the truth into a different version of God's will.
那现在有很多人，他们对这个教育开始淡化，或者已经开始更改他们的信仰。
And this is something that already happened in the apostolic church. That is why the Holy Spirit departed from the apostolic church.
那同样的事情发生在这个使徒时代的教会，到最后啊，圣灵就离开了教会。
And so since the True Jesus Church is the restored apostolic church, whatever happened to apostolic church will also happen in our church as well.
啊，既然真耶稣教会是复兴使徒的真教会。使徒时代的教会所面临的问题，我们真耶稣教会也同样会面临。
Of course, the difference in between the apostolic church and the true Jesus church in the end time is that true Jesus church will be perfected and Jesus will rule her forever.
这个使徒时代的教会跟末世的真教会不同的地方就是这个真教会将会持续到耶稣再来，而主耶稣将会在真教会永远作王。
And so therefore, whilst that it is very comforting and reassuring,
虽然这个真理或者是事实对我们来说是非常鼓舞我们的。
We mustn't underestimate the works of Satan to destroy and mislead as many people as possible into condemnation.
但是我们不要低估了撒旦的能力，他会迷惑许多的人，让他们失去他们的救恩，到最后落入了这个沉沦。
Especially in the end time, Jesus already says that lawlessness will increase.
尤其主耶稣说，在这个末世不法的事情将要增加。
And so therefore, the spiritual battle is going to increase in intensity.
所以这个属灵的征战将会越来越激烈。
So in the way that Satan corrupted the mind of Eve,
同样的好像这个撒旦的夏娃的这个思想。
Then in the corruption that happened to the apostolic church,
同样的这个使徒时代的教会也败坏了。
The corruption will also be sown in many people's minds.
在末世这个撒旦也会让这个败坏的种子撒在许多人的心中。
And so therefore, in the way that Satan's work is very subtle, we need to hold on to the truth in order to discern falsehood.
那因为撒旦的工作是非常的细腻，所以我们必须要坚持这个真理，才能够分辨这个异端或者是真理。
So we find it that falsehood and departure from the doctrines will come under different disguises.
这个假教训或者是让人离开教会的这些事情会 从不同的层面和不同的方式来显现。
It will be from upfront saying that I don't believe in true Jesus Church is the only true church for salvation.
他们很能很直接的告诉你说我不相信真耶稣教会是唯一得救的教会。
Then of course that is very easy to spot, isn't it?
这个对我们来说很简单，我们马上就能够辨认这个人的信仰。
But then they will be in different guises as well.
但是他们也有不同的不同的 方法来出现。
For example, they may not speak outrightly, they disagree that true Jesus Church is the only true church for salvation.
他们可能不直接了当地告诉你说他们反对真耶稣教会是唯一得救的教会。
But they may discourage members to speak the whole truth of the gospel.
但是他可能就想试图来阻挡信徒来传讲我们这个全备的这个教义。
And gradually, they may not even instill God's will about the true church in the members' hearts.
到最后，这个信徒的心中就没有这个神完全的这个旨意了。
Over time, the identity of the church as God's light to the world for salvation will dim further if we allow this to continue.
那如果这样的趋势不断的发展的话，这个真教会成为世界的唯一一盏亮光，就会慢慢的暗淡。
And so therefore today, we need to hold on to the truth and also deepen our understanding of the doctrines.
所以我们要紧紧地抓住这个真理，而且要增加我们对教义的认识。
Because what Satan is aiming for is changing our minds about the truth of God's will.
因为撒旦的宗旨就是要改变我们对这个真理跟这个神的旨意的认识。
If we love God and if we love the church, we cannot allow this to happen.
如果我们爱神或者是爱教会，我们当然是不容许这样的事情来发生。
Because the doctrine is God's command and God's rule.
因为教义就是神的诫命跟神的规章。
We cannot allow it to be changed.
我们不可能容许这样的事情来改变。
According to Proverbs chapter 30, verse 6,
根据这个箴言三十章第六节，
If we change any part of God's words,
那如果我们更改神话语的任何一个部分，
then he will find us as a liar.
那我们就成为一个说谎的人。
And according to Revelation chapter 22, verse 18 to 19,
根据这个启示录二十二章十八节到十九节的记载，
If you add or take away from God's word, then plagues will be added to us. The blessings that God has prepared will be taken away from us.
那如果我们是增添或者是我们删除这个启示录里面的所有的这些话语，这个神就会删去我们的福分，或者是将里面的灾祸加添给我们。
So we need to make sure that we are educating ourselves, our family, our IE classes, our IE teachers, our church board members, every single believer, even new believers, the God's doctrine.
所以所有的弟兄姐妹，我们自己，我们的家庭，所有的老师、教员，长老执事、传道，甚至是新受洗的，我们都必须在教义上有更深的认识。
Because if we love them, we need to teach them the truth. If we love our soul like Jesus loved our soul, we need to strengthen ourselves in God's doctrines.
如果我们爱我们自己的灵魂，爱他人的灵魂，我们必须要在这个教义上来加强自己。
So if we look into John chapter 6, verse 16 to 17.
如果我们看约翰福音第六章
John chapter 7 verse 16 to 17
对不起约翰福音第七章十六节到十七节
Here it tells us Jesus said my doctrine is not mine
这里主耶稣说我的教义或者是教训不是我自己的
Jesus said but his who sent me which means belongs to God
乃是那差我来者的就是属于神的。
So if anyone wills to do his will, he shall know concerning the doctrine whether it is from God or not.
人若立志遵行他的旨意，就必晓得这个教训或者是教义，或是出于神，或是出于凭自己意思说的。
So, here it tells us very clearly that God's doctrine has to do with the truth of God's will.
那我们看到这个神的教育就是跟神的旨意跟神的真理有直接的关系。
So that is why we would never ever think of changing God's will, isn't it?
那我们不可能会有这种更改神旨意的想法。
If you change the understanding of the truth of God's will, then you are committing a great sin.
那如果你更改神的教育或者是神的旨意，那你就是犯了一个非常大的罪。
Because you're misleading people, causing people to rebel against God.
啊，因为这样子的话，你就会啊误导人家，让人家误入歧途来啊违抗神的旨意。
So that is why we all should rise up and be insistent to the truth of God's will, i.e. God's doctrines of salvation.
啊，所以我们必须挺身而出啊，为神的教育来站稳这个立场。
Sometimes when we discuss about doctrine, it seems an argument about words.
那有些时候我们在讨论教育的时候啊，有些人觉得我们只是在字眼上做这个无谓的争辩。
But actually, it is Jesus who gave us the word of life.
但是我们要晓得这个啊，生命之道是主耶稣赏赐给我们的。
It's the words to eternal life.
是领我们到永生的这个话语。
So the understanding of God's will for our salvation can never ever be changed.
啊，所以我们对这个得救的教育是不可能的了解是不可能更改的。
Otherwise, we invite a great punishment from God.
啊，不然的话啊，我们就会引起神的愤怒跟神的惩罚。
We put ourselves in the team of or the group that seeks to destroy God's church.
啊，不然的话，我们就会参与那些要破坏教会的这个组织。
So therefore, we realize that God's doctrine of salvation comes from God Himself through Jesus Christ.
啊，所以这个得救的教义是从耶稣基督来的啊，耶稣基督的教训是从神那里来的。
That is why we must be super sensitive to any changes or any changes to the doctrines of salvation.
啊，所以我们必须对啊。啊，这个任何更要非常的敏感。
So according to 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 11 to 13,
啊，根据哥林多前书第二章十一节到第三节里面说到
，What happens when we view from God's doctrine first?
啊，如果我们啊。从神的教义的观点来出发来了解事情的话会发生什么事情
Because God's doctrine is revealed by God himself.
啊，因为这个神的教义是神启示我们的。
And so when we have the truth from God, then we are able to discern.
那当我们领受了从神来的真理之后我们才能够做出正确的判断。
If you don't have the truth, then how can we discern what is right, what is wrong?
那如果我们没有真理的话，我们怎么能够分辨什么是对，什么是错的呢？
And so therefore, in the true Jesus Church, we have received the true gospel from God.
啊，所以在真耶稣教会，我们已经从神那里领受了这个啊正确真正的这个救恩。
No part of God's will, no part of God's doctrine can ever be changed.
啊，所以神的教育、神的救恩是没有一个部分可以做更改的。
Because if it changes a little bit, then the next generation change a little bit, and then the next generation change a little bit, then basically God's will is being eroded. The spiritual understanding for salvation and God's will is being destroyed.
那如果每一个时代都更改一点点的话，过了许多的年代，那神的这个救恩跟神的旨意就完全的更改了。
Yeah, today, if we imagine when the truth is changed, then your descendants cannot be saved.
所以你现在要设想说，如果这个真理更改了，那你的后代就不可能得救。
And that should put inside of us a sense of resistance against such forces.
啊，所以我们了解到这种事情的严重性的话，我们就会啊强烈的反对啊这些教义方面的更改。
Because God's revealed doctrine allows us to discern what is right and what is wrong.
因为神启示我们的教训跟教义，让我们能够做分辨的真理的工作。
We find it in Colossians chapter 2 verse 12 tells us.
哥罗西书二章十二节告诉我们。
That God's doctrines allows us to have faith in the working of God.
神的教义让我们对神的工作有所了解。
So for example, we know that the truth tells us that when we are baptized, our sins are washed away.
我们认识到当我们接受洗礼的时候，我们的罪已经被洗去了。
If we are not baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, our sins cannot be washed away.
如果我们不是奉主耶稣圣名来接受洗礼的话，我们的罪不能够得赦。
So we can see God's doctrine reveals to us how God works.
所以这个神的教义解释给我们知道神的工作是如何的运行。
If someone say, oh, when you get baptized, head bow, not head bow, doesn't make a difference.
或者有些人可能说你洗礼的时候，你是否低下头都不重要。
What difference does it make if True Jesus Church is one church for salvation and there are other church for salvation? What difference does it make?
有些人说，如果真耶稣教会是让人得救的，还有其他教会也能够让人得救，这有什么区别呢？
And you say that everyone is speaking the same thing. What difference does it make?
那你说每个人都说同样的事情，那我们跟其他的教派有什么区别呢？
Why be so fussy about the detail?
那我们为什么要对这些细节这么执着呢？
But the question is what we hold the way God works?
但是问题就是我们所坚持的是否是神的工作呢？
If we are changing our understanding how God works and this is not what God revealed to us, then we are lying.
那如果我们要更改我们所领受的那这个更改过的教训跟神的真理是不符合的话，那我们就是说谎的。
And then we are misleading people, and that can never be God's will.
那到最后我们就是误人子弟这样子的话，这绝对不是神的旨意。
So when we turn to Isaiah chapter 8, verse 18 to 20,
那如果我们看以赛亚书第八章从十八节到二十节里面，
Even from the Old Testament, it tells us how to discern whether someone has light in them or not.
甚至从旧约圣经我们都可以学习到神教导我们如何分辨一个人是否是属于光明的。
If people are not speaking according to the truth from God's word,
那一个人如果不是按照神的话语来讲真理，
then we know they are not from God, there is no light in them.
我们知道他们不是属神的，他在他里面没有神的光。
So God's doctrine allows us to discern whether a person has God's light of truth in them.
所以神的教义让我们能够分辨一个人是否在神的是否有神的真光在他里面。
And that is very important, especially in the end time.
这个在尤其是在末日的时候，对我们来说是非常的重要。
So it is because there is a constant arising wave after wave of these falsehoods that is why we need to keep each other safe by having this doctrinal study.
所以因为在末日这些假教训将会一波又一波的来袭击我们，所以我们必须要用这个教育的课程来互相鼓励，来巩固我们的信仰。
It is not to put a heart of fear into our hearts.
这不是要让我们觉得非常的恐惧。
It is to let ourselves become alert to the spiritual battle ahead of us.
而是要让我们警醒来面对我们前面所要面对的这个属灵的征战。
Because one thing is very true.
有一件事是非常确实的。
Let's turn to Matthew chapter 28, verse 18 to 20.
我们请看马太福音18章18节到20节
Matthew chapter 28 verse 18 to 20
马太福音28章18节到20节
Here we can see that before Jesus ascended to heaven, Jesus spoke to his disciples.
在耶稣升天之前，他对他的门徒说道，
All authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth.
他说天上地下的权柄已经赏赐了给我。
In verse 19, Jesus told the disciples to make disciples of all nations by baptizing them.
19节说他的门徒要使万民做他的门徒。
Now if you look up verse 20, Jesus has taught the disciples.
那主耶稣已经教导了这个门徒。
Jesus has commanded the disciples.
主耶稣也吩咐他的门徒。
So Jesus also wants his disciples to teach other disciples to observe all things that Jesus commanded them.
他也吩咐了门徒必须要教导其他的信徒来遵守主耶稣给他们的吩咐。
And why is that essential? Because Jesus said, And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age.
为什么这非常重要呢？因为如果这样做的话，主会常与我们同在，直到世界的末了。
So in other words, when God's doctrine carries so much authority and the power of the one who has issued it,
既然这个神的话语带有这么大的权柄，因为是主耶稣所吩咐的。
Then you will find it that if a person departs from the doctrine, departs from the truth, then they lose God's abidance.
所以当一个人离去了这个真理，离去了神的教义跟教训的话，那神就不再与这个人同在了。
And so therefore, that is why the doctrines affect our salvation.
所以这个教义是直接影响我们的得救。
So today we totally need to rely on the Holy Spirit to study the truth, but also to keep the truth by the Holy Spirit.
所以我们必须要依靠圣灵来学习真理，也要依靠圣灵来遵行这个真理。
Now one thing is true.
有一件事是非常确实的。
God knows those who have faith in His doctrines.
神知道我们哪一位是对他的这个教义有信心的。
Yeah, he knows.
他神非常的清楚。
Just like God knows those who have true faith in Jesus or not.
神也非常清楚哪一些人对他是有真正的信心。
So God will be able to know and he will justify the one who has faith in Jesus.
因为神知道，所以他就会来让这些信他的人称义。
So, in other words, if a person has no faith in Jesus and his truth for salvation,
所以当一个人对耶稣还有他得救的真理没有信心的话,
then God will definitely not justify that person.
那神就不会称这个人为义。
But those who have faith in Jesus and the truth that God has given to us,
但是那些人对耶稣有信心的，对主耶稣赐给我们的真理有信心的人,
And he will bear witness.
那神就会为这些人做见证。
And so therefore today we need to hold on to the precious doctrines that God has given to the true Jesus Church.
所以今天我们要牢牢地抓住神所赏赐真耶稣教会得救的教义。
Today we need to understand by one church is how God always worked.
今天我们要了解神是借着他独一的真教会来运行操作跟工作。
That is how God works from the past, now, and in the future.
这是神一贯的作风，他从从前、现在到将来都是与这个原则来运行。
So I'm sure that some of us may even have doubts towards God only use one true church to save people, save the whole world.
可能有些人是会怀疑说神是否只是用一个教会来拯救全世界呢？
We may be questioned, we may be even have our doubts.
我们可能非常的怀疑或者有打很多的问号。
And that is why today we are needing to go step by step to strengthen our belief. How does God work according to his word?
所以今天我们要加强我们的信仰，我们要了解神的作风，神一贯的做法。
So that we are able to cut away any doubts, any uncertainty feeling inside of ourselves.
所以我们要把我们内心中所有的疑惑都要完全的铲除。
May the Lord guide us in this evening study and future studies.
愿主耶稣带领我们今晚上的查考，还有将来的这些学习。
Now, this ends my first part of the presentation.
啊，那是我这个第一部分的分享到这里结束。
Amen.
Amen.
We give thanks to God for Preacher Stephen's important reminders.
啊，我们感谢神，我们的史文斌传道给我们非常重要的提醒。
We know that the spiritual battle is before us right now.
啊，我们知道我们现在就在面临这个属灵的征战。
And now we have been reminded that the doctrines are God's words, His commands, and His will.
那我们现在被提醒到这个教义就是神的诫命、神的吩咐啊，跟神的规则。
And it cannot be changed.
啊，它是完全没有更改的余地。
And so we need to stand firm in the truth.
所以我们要在真理站稳脚跟。
So that we will not be deceived or be corrupted by false teachings.
这样子我们不会被错误的教训来迷惑、来败坏。
Let us stand up and not be discouraged to speak the complete doctrine of God.
所以我们要坚持的站起、挺身而出、为真理来做见证。
But grasp this opportunity to deepen our understanding.
我们要紧紧、把握住、这次的机会来对这个真理有深一步的了解。
So part of deepening our understanding is to identify what we don't know.
那要、对我们所认识的深一有深一步的了解，就是首先要了解我们不晓得的地方是在哪里。
And so now we'll have a group sharing.
现在我们要做分组的分享。
And so we have prepared a few questions to help us in the sharing.
在这个分享当中，我们有几个问题来让大家来思考。
And I will now share this in the chat as well, so you have it.
我们也在摆在这个聊天室里面有摆这个问题。
And we will split into two groups, English speaking and Mandarin speaking.
现在我要将大家分成两组，就是中文组跟英文组。
Now, once I open the breakout room, please look for the symbol to join the breakout room.
我现在要、把我们大家分组，然后你会看到要参加哪一个组。
And then you will have the option to join the English group or the Mandarin speaking group.
所以、之后你就有一个选择，你可以选择参加这个英文组或者是中文组。
So please select the right group.
请你选择正确的这个组别，照着你的语言的倾向。
But if you are having difficulty, just sit tight and we will help put you in the right group.
那如果你有问题的话，我们就帮助你来分组。
So we give thanks to God for our short group sharing.
感谢神，我们有这个简短的时间来做这个分享。
So even though it was short,
虽然分享的时间很简短，
a lot of important reminders were raised.
大家已经提出了很多的这个重要的这个提醒。
And you know, hopefully in the future we'll have more opportunities to share with one another.
希望在不久的将来，我们有更多的机会跟大家一起分享。
And you know, it is important that you know, as brethren, we can share and speak about the doctrines.
身为弟兄姐妹我们能够在这个教义方面来分享是来查考是非常的重要。
That way we can remind one another and keep ourselves in the truth.
这样子我们可以彼此的做提醒保守我们自己在真理里面。
So now we ask Preacher Stephen to continue with today's topic.
我们现在邀请石传道来继续讲解今天的这个题目。
New Lord Jesus Christ, I speak.
奉耶稣基督圣名说话。
We thank God now we enter into the part two.
我们感谢神，我们进入这个教义讲解的这个查考的这个第二阶段。
As I've said, that there are actually people who do not believe in true Jesus Church is the only true church for salvation.
我刚才已经说到，有些信徒是不相信真耶稣教会是唯一得救的教会。
Even some workers also don't believe as well.
甚至有一些工人也不相信真耶稣教会是 唯一得救的教会。
And so therefore, that is why it's so important for us to be alert.
所以我们必须要提高警惕。
But then we need to remember that God's doctrine is God's will.
但是我们要记得就是这个神的教义就是神的旨意。
Because some people may have this question.
有些人可能有这样的疑问。
How is it possible that God only used a few people to try to save the whole world?
有些人可能他的问题就是神怎么可能只是用一小撮的人来拯救全世界呢？
And so it is because of this feeling, it's impossible. God cannot use only a few people to save the whole world.
因为他们认为神不可能用这么少数的人来拯救全世界。
So therefore, that is why doubts arise in their hearts, and then they seek to change how they feel about the beliefs for the truth.
因为这样他们心中就起了这个怀疑，这样子他们就试图去更改他们的信仰。
In order to make themselves feel more acceptable.
这样子希望他们能够更让人接受。
But today we have learned that the doctrines is not only God's will.
今天我们学习到这个教义不单只是神的旨意。
Is that this is how God works.
这也是神工作的这个模式。
So for the remaining of the time, we are going to go into various examples in the Bible that one true church is how God works.
今天现在我们要用一些例子来说明这个独一真教会。
Because the whole idea is that how can God only use a few people to do this massive work?
他们的这个观点就是神怎么可能用这么少数的人来这样工作。
There are a few things I need to mention.
有几点我必须要先提醒大家。
According to 1 Timothy and 2 Peter,
根据提摩太前书还有彼得后书。
Jesus wants all people to come to the knowledge of the truth, and he does not want one person to perish.
神不希望任何人沉沦，他希望所有的人都能够来认识真理，来得救。
And so therefore, today, when God uses his way of saving people, it is the best way.
那神用的方法来拯救人类就是最好的方法。
So we need to look into the scriptures, how God operated, how God worked, in order for us to rest assured God knows what he's doing when he used one true church.
所以我们要看看圣经的例子，神是以前是如何的工作，这样子我们才能够很安心的相信神将会用他独一的真教会来拯救全世界。
Let's turn to Acts chapter 17.
请翻开《使徒行传》十七章。
Acts chapter 17, let's look at verse 26.
二十六节。
Verse 26.
使徒行传十七章二十六节。
And here it talks about how God had made from one blood every nation of men to dwell on all the face of the earth.
这里说神从一本造出万族的人住在全地上，并且预定他们的年限和所住的疆界。
So this tells us from two people fill the whole world.
在这里我们可以看到神的创作就是借由两个人他们就繁殖成为这个全世界的人口。
If we were at the start of the creation, one man, one woman, we will find that God wants to fill this whole world, we will think it may be impossible.
那如果我们在这个创世的起头来看，神当初才造 一对男女的话，而这对男女将要生养众多，遍满全地，我们可能不能够相信。
But then when we look into verse 26,
但是如果我们看到这个二十六节，
So since God has done the impossible to fill this whole world just from two people,
既然神已经做到我们认为不可能实现的事，就是从一本造出万有来遍满全地。
So in verse 26, it tells us that God has determined their pre-appointed times and the boundaries of their dwellings.
这里神说神预定了我们人类的年限和所住的疆界。
That means that God knows how to bring those who are his into salvation.
换句话说，神非常清楚，他如何将他的人来带领进入这个得救跟永生。
Because according to verse 27, he has determined their pre-appointed times and the boundaries so that they will seek after the Lord.
因为神已经预定了他们的年限和所住的疆界，要他们寻求神。
We thank God, even like places in Africa, so many people, so many countries.
就好像这在非洲有许许多多的国家，有许许多多的人。
God has able to reveal visions for people to look for the true Jesus Church.
神借着这个异象来带领这些人来寻找真耶稣教会。
So that is also evidence that God knows what he's doing.
这些都是非常明显的证据，让我们认识到神知道他在做什么。
Now let us look at Genesis chapter 12.
我们再看这个创世纪12章。
You see, God's choice of one body of people is not just in creation, but even at the calling of Abraham.
所以神拣选一个团体的人，不单只是在这个创世神造人类的时候我们看到的原则。
But even when God called Abraham as well.
甚至我们可以看到神拣选亚伯拉罕，他的原则也是不变的。
Now let's look at Genesis chapter 12, verse 1-3.
我们看这个创世纪12章第一节到第三节。
Here we can see that I will make you a great nation, verse 2, I will bless you and make your name great, and you shall be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and I will curse him who curses you, and in you all the families of the earth shall be blessed.
所以第二节说，我必叫你成为大国，我必赐福给你，叫你的名为大，你也要叫别人得福。为你祝福的，我必赐福与他；那咒诅你的，我必咒诅他。地上的万族都要因你得福。
If you view it from Abraham's point of view at that time, you would say, wow, all the families of the earth shall be blessed because of one person and one group of people.
那可能你在这个亚伯兰的时候，你看到神这样对他说，神要借着亚伯拉罕让地上的万族得福。
You may say that is impossible, but that is exactly what God did.
但是你可能在那时候认为这是不可能事，但是那这就是神的作为。
And so therefore today, when we realize this is God's choice of using one body of people to save the whole world, is nothing new.
所以我们看到从一开始神就是借着一个团体的人来拯救这个全世界，是神一贯的作风。
Was God successful?
那神是否成功了呢？
Very successful.
神的工作是非常的成功。
From history, we can see that God's promise is fulfilled.
从历史上我们看到神的这个应许都已经成全了。
Even through Galatians chapter 3, verse 26-27.
甚至在加拉太书3:26-27里面的这段的预言也已经成就了。
That in the true Jesus Church, those who are baptized are baptized into Christ are descendants of Abraham.
所以那些信耶稣的奉耶稣基督圣名接受洗礼的就成为亚伯拉罕的后裔。
And if you look into verse 29.
如果我们看这个加拉太书3:29
Galatians chapter 3 verse 29
加拉太书3:29
And if you are Christ, then you are Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise.
29节你们既属乎基督就是亚伯拉罕的后裔是照着应许承受产业的了。
So this gives us a very good understanding that God has actually achieved what he set out to do through one person, one group of people.
所以从这些不胜枚举的例子，我们就可以看到神是借着一人或者是一个组织的人来成就他的工作。
Let's look at another example.
我们再看另外一个例子。
In Noah's time, God only used one ark.
在挪亚的时代，神只用了一艘的方舟。
We may find it that if we lived in the time of Noah, we may say, oh, no, it's not enough. One ark, one family.No, it's not enough.
如果我们住在挪亚时代，我们可能对神说， 只是照一个方舟或者是拣选挪亚一家人是不足够的。
But then we find it that in those days there were many vessels.
啊，我们可能发觉到在挪亚的时代有很多不同的船只。
But there were no other vessels that were saved.
但是啊，另外一些船只并没有让他们得救。
There was only one ark that God gave the design to. He gave the design of the one ark to Noah.
啊，只有啊神的一个方舟，而神将这个方舟的这个蓝图交给了这个挪亚。
Let's turn to 1 Peter chapter 3 verse 20 to 21.
我们请看彼得前书第三章二十节到二十一节。
1 Peter chapter 3 verse 20 to 21.
彼得前书第三章二十节到二十一节。
So here it talks about that in the days of Noah, the ark was prepared.
就是在挪亚的时代这个方舟被预备了。
Eight souls were saved through water.
八口人是借着这个水来得救。
So God only used one ark.
神只用了一个方舟。
One family.
还有一家人。
Now the question is, did God fail?
那神是否失败了呢？
Of course not. God never fails.
当然没有，因为神从不失败。
If we judge by feeling, it says, God, you only save eight people. Your plan was not successful. Then what are we saying about God?
那如果我们凭我们自己的感觉，我们自己的感情来说啊，神你只救了八个人，那怎么可以算呢？那神的话又算什么呢？
It is not that God failed, it is man failed to believe.
不是神失败，而是这些人他们不相信神。
And so therefore today we need to remind ourselves God knows what he's doing.
所以今天我们必须要提醒我们自己，神知道他在做什么。
We need to come to know God before we think about changing the truth.
我们必须要先认识神，不然的话我们就要更改这个真理。
It is when we come to know God, we trust God, then his way is always the best way, is the right way.
那当我们认识到神，我们相信神，信任神，我们就知道神的方法是最好的方法。
If we turn to Genesis chapter 7 verse 22,
那如果我们看这个创世纪第七章二十二节
，Genesis chapter 7 verse 22，
创世纪第七章二十二节
，verse 22 says, "All in whose nostrils was the breath of the spirit of life, all that was on the dry land died."
二十二节，凡在旱地上鼻孔有气息的生灵都死了。
Today we need to realize that was God's judgment.
今天我们要认识到那就是神对这个世界的审判。
God did not fail.
神并没有失败。
God's word was executed.
那神的话已经成就了。
So when God saved Noah and his family,
当神拯救了挪亚和他的一家人，
God was successful in what he set out to do.
神所计划神的计划他已经完全的成就了。
So if we would not judge God to have failed in the Noah's time,
那如果我们认为神在挪亚时代并没有失败的话，
then why would we be hesitant that thinking that this will not work, many people will not be saved then?
那为什么我们会认为在末世借着真教会不会有许多人来得救呢？
It doesn't make sense.
这样的想法是说不通的。
Let's turn to another example about the one true church.
我们再看另外一个有关独一真教会的例子。
Let's turn to Ephesians chapter 5 verse 23.
以弗所书五章二十三节。
Now in Ephesians chapter 5 verse 23, Jesus is the husband and the church is the wife.
以弗所书五章二十三节。耶稣基督就是做丈夫的，那教会就是他的妻子或者是心腹。
And so therefore, Jesus conforms to God's design of marriage of one husband, one wife.
那主耶稣的作为跟神的这个计划就是一夫一妻的制度是完全吻合的。
And if you look into Ephesians chapter 5 verse 23,
那如果我们看以弗所书五章二十三节，
It tells us very clearly that Jesus is the savior of the body singular.
啊，这里说耶稣基督是教会全体的主，这个体是这个单数的。
So that means God's relationship with his people is monogamous.
啊，就换句话说，神跟他子民的这个关系是一夫一妻的关系。
Now, when you look into the history of God's people,
那如果你来考察这个神的子民的历史，
and God's people are so sinful and keep rebelling against God.
那这些神的子民是非常的罪恶，他们常常背逆神，常常犯罪得罪神。
But you find it that God stuck to His people. God did not depart from His one people.
但是神还是牢牢的与他的子民在一起，他并没有抛弃他的子民。
God used the same people in order to bring Jesus out from His people.
Can you repeat that?
God stuck to with His people, and through His people, Jesus came forth.
Oh, okay. 那神是牢牢的守住他的子民，而且主耶稣是从这个以色列人出来的。
And so therefore, we find that God never changed His people, but stuck to His people, and His salvation came.
So, 所以神并没有更换他的子民，神只有拣选他的一个的子民，而且牢牢的跟他们锁在一起。
If we were living it throughout the history of Israel, we may have given up.
那如果我们看这个以色列人的历史，如果我们是神的话，我们可能早就放弃了以色列。
But yet God never gave up on His people.
但是神从来没有放弃他的子民。
And He continued to regard Himself as the husband and His people as His wife.
他一直把自己当为这个他的子民的丈夫，而他的子民为他的妻子。
Let's turn to Hosea chapter 2, verse 16.
我们请看何西亚书二章十六节。
Hosea chapter 2, let's look at verse 16.
何西亚书二章十六节。
Verse 16. And it shall be in that day, says the Lord, that you will call me my husband and no longer call me my master.
十六节，耶和华说，那日你必称呼我医师，就是丈夫的意思，不再称呼我巴利，就是我主的意思。
Verse 19 and 20.
我们再看十九节、二十节。
I will betroth you to me forever. Yes, I will betroth you to me in righteousness and justice, in loving kindness and mercy. Verse 20. I will betroth you to me in faithfulness, and you shall know the Lord.
十九节，我必聘你，永远归我为妻，以仁义、公平、慈爱、怜悯聘你归我，也以诚实聘你归我，你就认识我耶和华。
So therefore, it doesn't matter that the Israelites are departed from God, but God never depart from His people.
所以不论这个以色列民如何的对待神，甚至他们离弃神，神还是从不离弃他们。
God was still faithful to His covenantal promise.
神对他的这个约是信实的。
And so that He would not give up on His people.
他永远不会放弃背弃他的子民。
So when you look at God's love for His people, it tells you that the idea of the one true church is not a new one.
所以如果我们看神与他子民的关系，我们就了解到这个独一的真教会的这个观念不是一个新颖的观念。
Because the way that God works, He treats His people as His wife.
因为神的这个他的一贯的作风就是他将他的自己的子民看为他的妻子。
And he is the most faithful. He will be faithful to the end.
神是最忠心的，神必对他的心腹忠心到底。
So from that point of view that God has a monogamous relationship with his people, then we can say one true church, the belief is very sound.
所以我们看到神跟他子民的关系是一夫一妻的关系，所以这个独一真教会的这个观念是正确的。
Let's turn to Ephesians chapter 1.
我们再看以弗所书第一章。
Let us look at another concept, that of one body and one spirit.
我们看一个一体跟一灵的这个观念。
Let's turn to Ephesians chapter 1.
以弗所书第一章。
Ephesians chapter 1 verse 22 to 23.
以弗所书一章二十二节到二十三节。
Here it says, and he put all things under his feet and gave him to be head over all things to the church, verse 23, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all.
22节又将万有伏在他的脚下，使他为教会做万有之首，教会也是他的身体，是那充满万有者所充满的。
So one thing we know here, it says that the church is the body of Christ.
所以这里告诉我们说教会就是耶稣的身体。
And we need to notice that God gave Jesus to be head over all things to the church.
那神已经使万物伏在主耶稣的脚下，使耶稣基督成为教会之首。
So today we need to remember one true church must not be detached from her Savior.
所以我们今天要了解就是独一的真教会不可能跟他的救主来分割。
That means to say we cannot view the church by herself or just a group of people on a physical level.
所以我们不可能把教会看成一个独立的这个团体。
We need to,
或者是个自立的团体。
Yeah, we need to understand that we need to view it spiritually, who is the head of this church.
因为我们要从属灵的观念来看教会，我们要看教会的头是谁。
Jesus is the head of this church.
耶稣基督是教会的头。
He is the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. He is the one who lived and died and rose up from the dead and have received all authority.
因为耶稣基督是万王之王，万主之主，他是死而复活。现在已经拥有天上地下一切的权柄。
So when we underestimate the one true church, are we also underestimating Jesus, our Lord, God, Savior, ability to save everyone?
那如果我们小看了真教会，那我们不是小看了耶稣的头，耶稣我们的头就是这个独一的救主来拯救全世界吗？
Don't forget, Jesus is the head of this one body.
不要忘记了，耶稣就是这个这个一个身体的头。
Now, if we believe Jesus used a few hundred people in Acts chapter 2 to spread the gospel to the rest of the world at that time,
那如果我们看《使徒行传》第二章的时候，我们看到神耶稣借着120个人将这个福音传给当时的全世界。
Then why is it that we find it impossible to believe true Jesus Church is to spread throughout the world?
那我们为什么不能够相信神能够借着真耶稣教会将他的福音传到全世界呢？
In actual fact, if we view it now, we should have more faith God is accomplishing his will.
那如果我们看今天的现况，我们应该对神更有信心，说他的旨意正在实行成就当中。
Now, if we take a step back and go back to 1917,
那如果我们往后看，就是在历史上来看这个1917年。
God used one person here, one person here, one person there.
神拣选了几个零零散散的几个人。
And then God brought them together.
然后神将他们集合在一起。
Gospel began to spread far and wide.
然后神借着他们将他的福音传到很多的地方。
At that time when there was only 50 people, we may have doubted.
那刚开始只有50个人，我们可能可以起怀疑。
You are saying 50 people, and they will be able to spread the gospel to the rest of the world?
只有拣选了50个人就能够将福音传遍天下吗？
But is this not what has happened in the true Jesus Church?
这难道不是真耶稣教会所发生的事情吗？
From east to west, to the north, to the south.
从东边到西边，从北边到南边。
Is this not God's work?
难道这不是神的作为吗？
So today it should be, since we are part of the one true church in the end time, we are standing on the evidence that God is fulfilling his will according to the Bible.
既然我们现在是真耶稣教会的一份子，我们就应该很清楚地知道神借着真耶稣教会在成就他的旨意。
So don't forget, the head of this one church is Jesus Christ himself.
不要忘记了，这个我们教会的头就是主耶稣基督他本身。
Let's turn to Ephesians chapter 4.
我们再看以弗所书第四章。
Ephesians chapter 4 verse 4.
以弗所书四章第四节。
Yeah, there is one body and one spirit.
身体只有一个，圣灵只有一个。
Now, this is very important to understand.
这是我们必须要了解非常重要的一点。
Today, if we doubt in true Jesus Church is the only true church for salvation, then we are underestimating the power of the Holy Spirit.
那如果今天我们不相信真耶稣教会是神唯一得救的教会，我们就是小看了、藐视了圣灵的工作。
We forget that the Holy Spirit is not a thing. The Holy Spirit is God Himself.
我们忘记了圣灵不是一样东西，圣灵是神本身。
According to the truth, God created the heavens and the earth by His Spirit, by His Word.
根据真理，我们知道神借着他的灵，借着他的话，创造了宇宙万有。
By his spirit, by his word, everything is sustained even until now.
借着他的话与他的灵，神是托住万有直到今天。
Are we saying that the Holy Spirit in true Jesus Church is not God's spirit?
我们难道是我们这样的观点，就是说真耶稣教会的圣灵不是神的灵吗？
If we say it's not, then we blaspheme God.
那如果我们说真耶稣教会的圣灵不是神的灵的话，我们就是在亵渎神。
Since the Holy Spirit, there's only one, and the same Holy Spirit fills the true Jesus Church.
既然圣灵只有一个，而神的灵充满着我们真耶稣教会。
And God is able to do everything beyond a human means.
神所能神的工作。是超出我们的想象。
Then who are we to underestimate God's ability to save all who are his?
那我们怎么可以小看神的能力，他能够拯救所有属他的人呢？
It really doesn't make sense.
这样的想法根本就是不合理的。
It makes perfect sense that Jesus only has one church because he is the head of this one church.And his one spirit who created the heavens and the earth out of nothing is the same spirit that will work.
所以我们正确的想法就是神只有一位他的教会就是他的妻子也只有一个，而他的灵也只有一个，借着他的独一的灵，他创造的宇宙万物也能够成就一切的事情。
Let's turn to John chapter 15.
我们再看这个约翰福音十五章。
John chapter 15.
约翰福音十五章。
Now John chapter 15 verse 1 speaks of God's church.
约翰福音十五章第一节提到神的教会。
Let's look at verse 1.
第一节。
Verse 1. I am the true vine and my father is the vine dresser.
我是真葡萄树，我父是栽培的人。
Verse 5.
第五节。
I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit, for without me you can do nothing.
第五节，我是葡萄树，你们是枝子，藏在我里面的，我也藏在他们里面，这人就多结果子，因为离了我，你们就不能做什么。
So these verses describes that Jesus is the true vine and we are the branches.
所以这里告诉我们，主耶稣就是真葡萄树，我们是枝子。
So according to the Bible, how many vines does God have?
根据圣经的话来说，神到底有几棵葡萄树呢？
According to Isaiah chapter 5, there is only one vineyard.
根据以赛亚书第五章，只有一个葡萄园。
And then when we look into Isaiah chapter 27, it's the same one.
在以赛亚书27章也是提到这个这个同样的唯一的这个葡萄园。
And so therefore, it tells us that God only has one true vine.
所以这告诉我们说神只有一个属于他的真葡萄树。
So today we find it that God sticks to his salvation plan.
所以我们看到神是坚持他这个得救的计划。
We may say, there are people who are doubting the true Jesus church. Maybe we should change our beliefs to encourage more people to stick to the true Jesus church.
有些人的想法就是 有很多人开始怀疑真耶稣教会，所以我们要更改我们的信条来迎合他们的想法，使到更多人能够来信从真耶稣教会。
But today, if we do this, isn't it that we are breaking ourselves off from Jesus himself?
那如果我们这样做的话，难道我们不是从耶稣这个真葡萄树身上来断掉自己吗？
Because Jesus himself is the way, the truth, and the life.
因为主耶稣就是道路、真理、生命。
If we are preaching and changing God's plan, God's will,
那如果我们在更改神的计划和神的旨意，
will he not cast us out as a branch and it withers?
神难道不会将我们像这个枝子这样折断丢弃，然后我们枯干吗？
So therefore today we cannot afford to compromise just to please people, thinking, oh, if we do this, then more people will stay in the church.
那所以今天我们不可能妥协来迎合人的想法，希望借这个想法让更多人留在教会里面。
Today we must be very careful on how we how our attitude towards the God's doctrines.
所以今天我们必须要非常小心我们对这个教义的这种态度。
So today, how should we renew ourselves?
所以今天我们要如何来更新自己？
When we come back to John chapter 15,
如果我们再看回约翰福音十五章。
Today, if we believe in the truth,
今天我们若相信真理，
then and we are, Jesus is the true vine,
那耶稣就是真葡萄树，
and we are the branches,
我们是枝子，
what we should do is abide in him and let him abide in us so that we can bear much fruit.
我们所要做的就是常在主里面，主也常在我们里面，使到我们能够多结果子。
Now if you look at verse 7,
如果看第七节，
Jesus said,
耶稣说，
If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire and it shall be done for you.
第七节，你们若常在我里面，我的话也常在你们里面，凡你们所愿意的祈求就给你们成就。
Praise the Lord.
感谢主。
This is exactly how Jesus works.
这就是主耶稣工作的这个方法跟惯例。
We find it in Africa, we find that there is a church which seems to prosper amazingly well in times past.
在非洲我们看到有一个教会，它是非常的这个发展的非常的好。
But yet, after a short time, God began to depart from the church.
但是神已经离弃了这个教会。
Because the church became corrupt.
因为这个教会已经败坏了。
So very few people remained in the true Jesus church.
因为那个当地的教会败坏了，所以非常少的人愿意留在真耶稣教会。
But thank God.
但是感谢神。
The few people that remain in the true Jesus church abided in Jesus and the words of Jesus abide in them.
那剩下的小撮的人，他们是藏在主里面的，而且神的话是藏在他们里面。
They did not lose the identity that they are the only true church for salvation.
他们并没有失去他们是独一得救的教会的这个身份。
Even though they were laughed at when they started to preach to people.
虽然他们向别人传福音的时候，别人讥笑他们。
Slowly but surely God manifest signs and miracles and the truth was spread.
那 慢慢的神就借着他们彰显神的权柄跟神迹奇事，然后后来就越来越多人来信主。
One generation of workers rise up by another generation.
啊，一代又一代的工人不断的兴起。
And so therefore today, this tells us very clearly.
啊，所以今天啊，这啊，给我们一个很清楚的信息。
In the true Jesus Church, there is the abidance of God.
啊，在真耶稣教会有神的同在。
The main thing is, are we abiding with Jesus himself?
那 我们要问自己的就是我们是否常在主里面。
If we let the words of Jesus abide in us, allow the truth to be in our hearts with conviction,
那如果我们让神的话语存在我们心中，我们是确信这个神的道理。
Then we should decide and pray in this way.
那我们必须要以这样的方式来祷告。
Lord Jesus, I am completely devoted to you and to your church.
啊，主耶稣基督，我是全心全意的，啊，对你是专心的，对你的教会也是全心全意的。
Just like in the apostolic time, there was only few people that was your church.
啊，就好像在使徒时代刚开始的时候，只有很少的人是属于你的教会。
I believe that you will also prosper the true Jesus Church wherever I am.
我相信啊，不论我在什么地方，你将会兴起你的真耶稣，你的真教会。
If we desire, then we should ask it without reservation.
那如果我们有这样的想法，我们必须毫无保留的来这样向神来祈求。
So therefore, instead of doubting we are only the one true church, we should embrace it. And take it into prayer.
啊，我们与其去怀疑我们是否是独一得救的教会，我们应该完全的信相信，来在祷告中向神祈求。
You will find in the way that God worked with other true Jesus churches that are firmly founded in the truth, God will also work with you.
啊，这样子你会发现在不同的地方啊，那些完全信服神的真耶稣教会，神会。不断的动工在你的地方教会，如果你这样做，神也同样的会动工。
Let's turn to one more example.
我们再看啊，另外一个例子。
Let's turn to Acts chapter 7.
使徒行传第七章。
Acts chapter 7.
使徒行传第七章。
Let's look at verse 38.
三十八节。
Acts chapter 7, verse 38.
使徒行传第七章三十八节。
This is he who was in the congregation in the wilderness with the angel who spoke to him on Mount Sinai, and with our fathers are the one who received the living oracles to give to us.
38节，这人曾在旷野会中和西乃山上与那对他说话的天使同在，又与我们的祖宗同在，并且领受活泼的圣言传给我们。
So here we can see it described the Israelites as God's people, God's congregation.
在这里讲到以色列人是神的子民，是神的会众。
And this congregation was in the wilderness guided by the angel.
这些神的子民跟会众在旷野中是被神的天使带领。
And we find it that the living oracles was given to them.
这个活泼的圣言已经被传给他们。
So this is how God is working.
这也是今天神如何的在我们当中来工作。
So in the Old Testament, God gave the living oracles to Israel.
在旧约的时候神将他活泼的圣言传给以色列人。
God moved in one congregation who was in the wilderness.
神的灵在这个旷野当中属于神独一的这个团体当中运行。
And God magnificently fulfilled his plan for his people even until now.
所以神在当时一直到今天都一直在他子民当中成就他的计划。
So we can imagine at that time, these Israelites, when we look at the whole wide world, they are a very small group of people.
那如果我们看全世界的这些以色列人，他们是一个非常是算是少数的民族。
But God sanctified them, and they, in His eyes, were His only people.
但是神已经 将他们分别为圣，所以在神的眼中，他们就是属于神的子民。
If we do not deny that,
那如果我们不否认这点，
that God has a small congregation and those were only His people,
那神当时神的子民是非常少数的，这些是属神的人。
Then it doesn't make sense why we should doubt about ourselves as God's only people.
那我们为什么今天会怀疑自己是属于神的独一的教会呢？
There's no need for it.
我们根本不需要这样子来想。
So therefore today, even though technology, information, our knowledge of the world has changed and increased,
虽然今天这个科技不断的发展，我们的这个知识不断的不断的在进步。
We must not let these human thinking cause us to doubt in God's way of working.
那我们不要让人的想法来影响我们对神的认识，还有神工作的方法。
From the truth, from the word of God, from God's doctrine, we should make up our mind and dedicate ourselves to the truth.
所以从这个圣经里面的教训跟神的话语，我们必须要专注在真理方面。
If we do this,
如果我们这样做的话，
then perhaps by God's mercy, He will use us.
那可能借着神的慈悲跟怜悯，神会用我们来成就他的工作。
And perhaps we will be able to see the fulfillment of the prophecy given to Haggai.
这样子我们就可能看到哈该先知所说的预言实现。
That the glory of the latter temple will be greater than the former.
这个后来的殿的荣耀必大于先前的殿。
May the Lord Jesus fill us with the Holy Spirit.
愿我们主耶稣基督使到我们被圣灵充满。
May the truth continue to abide in us.
愿真理不断地住在我们里面。
May God continue to guide the few weeks that we have together to study His doctrines.
愿主耶稣继续地带领我们这几个礼拜在这个教义上的查考。
May we ask the Holy Spirit to guide us into all truth.
愿神的灵带领我们进入一切的真理。
Hallelujah, Amen.
Hallelujah, Amen.
We give thanks to God.For the Old Testament and New Testament examples cited by Preacher Stephen.
我们感谢主耶稣我们的师传道引证了这个新约圣经跟旧约圣经许多的例子。
Indeed, it is very clear that there is only one body of Christ, one church of God where salvation can be found.
而借着这个身体，我们才能够得到这个得救的福音。
By one church is how God has always worked, yesterday, today, and forever.
借着神的独一的教会不论是在从前现在或者是将来，神都是以这个原则来操作。
Today we have come to understand that this is the will of God.
今天我们了解到这就是神的旨意。
It's His power and authority.
也是神的能力跟权柄。
In fact, it is God's testament of His love to every single one of us.
这也见证了神对我们每一位信徒的爱。
Therefore, let us trust God.
所以我们必须要信靠神。
Have faith in Him.
对神有信心。
Be faithful children of God.
我们要作为神忠心的儿女。
Therefore, as we live in the end times,
我们现在活在这个末世。
Let us preserve our hearts and minds in the pure word of God.
我们要借着神纯正的话语来保守我们的心思意念。
So that without doubt, we can testify with absolute faith that we belong to the one true church.
这样子我们就是毫无怀疑的来见证我们是属于这个独一的得救的真教会。
So because of time, we shall now conclude with our final hymn. Let's sing hymn 215.
因为时间关系，我们现在要做这个唱诗来结束，唱诗215首。
give thanks to God for guiding us through our first doctrinal study session.
我们感谢主带领我们的第一次的这个教义的学习。
For myself, it has been a timely reminder on how we should not be complacent in learning the doctrines.
对我而言这个是一个非常好的这个提醒我们对我们这个教义的这个认识不能自满。
As we live in this world, we must recognize our precious identity as children of God.
我们住在这个生活在这个世界上，我们必须要时时的记得自己是神儿女的这个尊贵的身份。
May we live worthy of our calling.
我们必须活的我们的活的样式必须要符合我们被召的身份。
Continue to strive forward in our study.
我们在这个学习真理方面要不断的前进。
That we are able to contend earnestly for the faith.
我们能够极力的尽心协力的为真道来争辩。
In this way, we can ensure our personal salvation.
这样子我们第一方面可以确保我们自己个人的得救。
We can defend the truth.
我们可以捍卫真理。
And preach the gospel to those near and far.
我们也可以将这个福音传给近处跟远处的人。
So, let us all end with a thanksgiving prayer.
我们现在要做这个感谢结束的祷告。
Again, if you are comfortable, please unmute your mics.
如果你觉得可以的话，那你可以打开你的这个麦克风来一起祷告。
Let us all kneel down and pray.
我们一起跪下来祷告。
In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray.
Thank you.
To God, our first doctrinal study session ends here.
感谢主，我们这个第一个礼拜的这个教义查考在这里结束。
Just a quick reminder that we'll continuing our study of the One True Church next week, same time.
我们下个礼拜将会在同一个时间继续来查考独一真教会。
And it will be led by preacher F.F. Chong.
下个礼拜将会由张富华传道来主领。
So may the Lord bless you all.
愿主祝福大家。
May you all have a safe week.
愿大家这一周能够过得很平安。
God bless and farewell.
愿主祝福大家。愿大家平安。